Spain, and we went to Santiago de Compostela, where we were with some Taiwanese, and they, on Sunday, they said, can we go to the church with you? Will you take us to the church? So I said, yes. So we went to the church, and as luck would have it, it was an occasion when 12 strapping young priests lowered a huge silver censer and sent it swinging about 100 feet each way over the heads of the audience, delivering holy smoke everywhere. Well, when we were on that trip, we also went on a little tour of the countryside and got to the house of the local poet. And the local poet, Rosalia de Castro, is so well known locally that, even the taxi driver who took us to the airport, I said, we went to see Rosalia's house. And he said, adios, Fuentes. And then recited her Farewell to Life, which is quite a long poem. He knew it by heart. Anyway, this is for Rosalia de Castro. On the mountain, an artist's chiseled granite commemorates writers born on the great peninsula's edge. Mist rolls its veils around the heart's intimate abyss. Wild horses stamp the grass and canter away through clouds, swathing a place weighted with myth, cradle of bones from the unencumbered dead. Born down here, where bird-thronged estuaries mix fresh water with salt tides of the sea. Dawn, quiet grove of oaks. You led us to rough-hewn rocks, delicate in equipoise. The dolmen's art endures like crags. Graffito. Through her villa's sun-filtering windows, Rosalia smiles at figs she planted with olive, lemon, grape. Words burst across her tongue, all the juice of life. Emotions leap and cling, surprising as wild flowers, pushing intensities of colour between weathered rocks on the wind-dishevelled shore. Rose petals fall one by one from Rosalia's generous lips. In the village bar across the way, flies buzz the hand of one who paints that now familiar face and her farewell to life, learned by heart in local speech. Poet, your clothes hang empty and cold in your room, but your words are warm and filled with your presence. I take them with me like the gift of a friend. And when we were looking